Okay.
Here's our next letters round. Vic, it's your choice this time.
Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Vic. N.
And another?
D.
And a vowel?
O.
And another?
E.
And a consonant, please.
Z.
Oh. A vowel, please?
I.
A consonant, please.
D.
Another consonant?
S.
And a final vowel.
And a final E.
And time starts now. How many this time, Ryan?
I think I have a 7.
Okay, Vic?
I think I have a 6 not written down.
Okay, well, let's have yours first then, Vic.
Noised.
Noised. And Ryan?
Noddies.
Noddies.
Okay, noddy is a foolish person. It's an old term, and that's absolutely fine. Noise as a verb is also fine. Yeah, it's archaic, actually. It's to talk about or make something known publicly, to make noise about something. Mm. Very good, both.
Anything more than 7?
You got dozens, didn't
dozens
you? Which is
six.
Great.
Yeah.
But I got zoids, which I thought should be a word, but it's not. So I'm going to have a word with Mr. Dictionary and say, sort that out. It should be in there.
Ryan has moved on to 56. Vic is on 22 at the moment. Here's our next letters round. Ryan, your choice.
Start with the vowel again, please.
Thank you, Ryan. O.
The consonant.
T.
A vowel.
E.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
W.
Consonant.
R.
A vowel.
A.
Another vowel.
E.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final M.
And here's the countdown clock. Vic?
Just a 6, I'm afraid.
And Ryan?
Stick with a 6, yeah.
OK, what's yours, Ryan?
Townie.
And yours, Vic?
And the same.
Same. Yeah, it's popped up before, hasn't it?
It so. Has, Townie. Yeah, just think of it normally as IE, but you can spell it with a double E, so that's fine.
We got what else 8? Has come up over there?
We got an 8.
An 8?
Watermen. So a waterman is an oarsman who has attained a particular level of knowledge or skill, and then obviously watermen.
Six apiece, though, for Ryan and for Vic. And again, they can just take a little breather because we're off to Dictionary Corner. It's Origins of Words time with Susie. Anything involving travel this
yes,
week by any chance?
Holidays.
Holidays.
I have to do the holiday bit vicariously through Amanda. I thought I'd start with staycation because, like it or love it, it has to be one of the candidates for Words of the Year. I think most of us hate it, but it's obviously a stay-at-home vacation fueled by the need to save money or to save the environment. And then I started thinking about vacation itself, and that comes from the same root as the word vacant, which means empty. So a vacation is an empty place that we need to fill with leisure. And a holiday, meanwhile, most of us know, was a holy day. That's where that comes from. And a common feature of sacred things, obviously, they mustn't be desecrated or damaged in any way. And holy comes from the word whole. And days set aside for religious festivals were called holy days by the Anglo-Saxons because they used to use those days to go to church. And because holidays and feast days in calendars were written or printed in red, a red letter day came to be a term for something very special. And actually, the system of highlighting something in red goes right back to the Romans, and it's the source of our word rubric, which means red earth or pigment.
Here's our next numbers round. Vic, it's your selection.
Rachel, I'm thrilled to ask for an inverted T.
An inverted T.
the wonders of countdown. Thank you. One for the top five small. Thank you, Vic.
Thank you.
So for this round, we've got 4, 5, 1, 9, 2, and the large one, 50. And the target to get, 988.
30 seconds to reach that target. A 988, the target then. Ryan, how close?
988.
And Vic?
988.
OK. Vic, let's hear your version then, please.
OK. 5 times 4 is 20.
5 times 4 is 20.
20 times 50 is 1,000.
1,000.
And take away the 9, the 1 and the 2.
9 and the 1 and the 2 for 12 to take away. Brilliant. 988.
Ryan, same method?
Yep.
Perfect. Yes.
Yeah. Well done. Here's another teaser for you. The words this time are nice girl. Nice girl. And the clue, a nice girl, but more emotionally dependent than the others. A nice girl, but more emotionally dependent than the others. A nice girl, but more emotionally dependent than the others. She is clingier. That's the answer to our teaser. Ryan's on 72. Vic's clinging on at the moment. He's on 38. Ryan, it's your choice of letters.
I'll start with a vowel, please.
Thank you, Ryan. O.
Consonant.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
Consonant.
P.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
T.
A vowel.
I.
A consonant.
J.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final Q.
And here's the countdown clock. Vic, how many?
7.
And Ryan?
7.
OK, what's yours, Ryan?
Deposit.
And yours, Vic?
The same.
Yeah, deposit for 7 for both Ryan and for Vic. Amanda, Susie, what have you got?
A couple of other 7s. We've got topside and joisted. I like the collective groan whenever a cue comes up. Oh. But those are the only 2 that we could find, wasn't it?
Yeah. 7 as good as it gets, and Ryan and Vic both found a 7. Means that Ryan's moved on to 79 and Vic has 45.